it was a very natural band. There was a concerted effort not to be showbiz, not to be Tin Pan Alley, not to be celebrity star type looking. Everyone dressed down, they didn't dress up. We deliberately cultivated a sort of working class, unkempt kind of attitude and look, because we didn't want to be part of that kind of cabaret feel that, that pop music was. And I think that that really sort of summed up our attitude to music as well. And so when the management said, we need a single, we said, we're not a singles band.
No, we'd been told we had to go and make a single. Yeah, go and make a single.
Was that, what was the other one? Lonely Road or something? Was that on the B-side of that?
I can't remember. But all I know is we spend all day in the studio going nowhere, you know, make a single, yeah. It's like bake a cake, you know, it's not quite the same thing. And we gave up about 8 o'clock, wasn't it? Went down, what was it, Newman Arms? Or?
We went Newton Arms, yeah.
Newton Arms, yeah.
And we got pretty plastered. And by 10:30, and they started kicking people out. Richie and I went back first to the studio, staggered, I'd say. And he picked up the guitar and he started playing this riff. And I said, yeah, that'll do. Or words to that effect. And he said, no, that's Ricky Nelson's version of Summertime. I said, well, I've never heard of it.
And that was the first thing that came out. And we went into just a basic shuffle.
Why don't we just do it? So I don't know. And by that time, Pacey had come back and John had come back and they all sort of joined in. And within, I mean, half an hour, we just, all right, verse, 8 bars for verse, fine, right, need another little bit. How about do 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 do? All right, fine, that'll do. Bang. And it was just instant and drunken and fun.
And in his somewhat liquid state, he came out with this sort of semi-nonsense lyric.
So what are we going to write about? Black Knight. Black Knight. Oh, don't feel so bright. He said, that'll do. Right. Can't see dark light. Hey, drunk, you know. We just wrote the most banal lyrics we could think of, thinking that it was a wasted session anyway, that what we were doing would probably end up with some obscure B-side, and that the whole day had been a waste.
But it all fit together rather well, and I started thinking, well, what wouldn't you play in the drum fills in this one? So I'll play that.
Yeah, right.
That was it. We did it in about, I don't know, 10 minutes, very quickly, and lo and behold, it went to number one in England.
Thank you.
I don't think anybody knows what the lyrics still mean today, do
they? Roger and I often have conversations. You got any idea what that song's about? No.